Welcome to the session of Information Technology. Today we are going to discuss the various ways of editing a document. All of you have used cut, copy and paste commands. Do you know when you cut a document where the document disappears? Or when you copy a document and when you paste it some other location, from where this document is pasting? Today, let us see more about this cut, copy and paste commands. I have brought a text on the screen. Now, I want to cut a selected portion of it. So, first of all, I have to select the text which I want to cut it. Now, the Home tab has a clipboard group in which there is a cut button. Just click on this button. Its shortcut is Ctrl plus X. Where this text actually goes? It goes to a temporary area of the operating system known as clipboard. So clipboard is a location where the cut or copy text is stored. Now I have to bring back this document to some other location. Just click on the location where you want to paste it. Go to the clipboard group again and click on the paste button. You can see from the clipboard this document appears to the selected area. Now I have to copy a text. So I am selecting the area which I have to copy. Now going to the clipboard group and clicking on the copy button. Now where I have to paste this, just click on the mouse and paste. You can see the document which I have copied, it has pasted from the clipboard. So several times we can paste it once if you are pasting the document into the clipboard. So what is the difference between the cut and the copy? The cut command deletes original text and it moves to the clipboard, whereas the copy command makes a copy of it and that copy is pasting to the new location. Next, we will discuss about the find and replace options in the MS Word. The find option can be used to search for a particular word in the document. So it searches the document, entire document, and it shows wherever the particular word is repeating. The replace option can be used to replace this particular word with another word so that the same word replaces from all the places wherever it is repeating. How can you get this find and replace option? It is available under the Home tab editing group. You can see the Home tab has an editing group in which there are find and replace buttons. Now click on this find option. Then you can see a navigation pane appears to the left side of the document and there you type the text which you want to search for. As you start to type the word, then the word searches entire document and it just points with some colors wherever the particular word is repeating. The keyboard shortcut is Ctrl plus F. We can use the replace option from this navigation pane's right side drop-down menu also. When you click on this drop-down menu, you can see there is a replace button. Then the replace dialog box comes. Here you have to add find what, then which word you want to search it. Add the word in this find what dialog box and replace with, give the new word to which the word has to be replaced. So automatically you can see the entire word will be replaced with the new word. Ctrl plus H is a shortcut key to open the find and replace dialog box. Next we will see how can we jump to a particular page number. When you are working in a large document, it becomes difficult to scroll down the pages to reach on a particular page. For example, you have 200 pages of document. You want to move to the 100th page directly. We can use a feature of go to. In the find and replace dialog box, you can see the go to tab. Just click on this go to tab. Then it is asking go to what, pages. Select the pages and then right side you have to specify to which page number you have to move and click on the OK. You are able to see the specified page on your screen directly. Let us see now how spelling and grammar tool works in MS Word. We all make mistake while typing a document. And you can see a red wavy underline comes when there is a spelling mistake and a green wavy underline comes when a grammatical mistake happens. What do we do normally when you see this red wavy underline or a green wavy underline? You just click on this right button where the mistake is there and it shows the correct suggestions and you make the changes accordingly. But we can do every corrections at once with the help of the dialog box, spelling and grammar dialog box. Let us see how it works. Click on the review tab. Under the proofing group, there is spelling and grammar tool is there. Click on it. You can see the spelling and grammar dialog box comes. In this dialog box, you are able to see all the spelling mistakes at once in red color. And each spelling mistake suggestions will be there down. You can select the correct spellings from there. Right side you can see there are a lot of buttons available like ignore once, ignore all, add to dictionary, change, change all, auto correct, etc. So you can apply any of those buttons according to your wish. You can use the shortcut key F7 for the spelling and grammar mistake. Now let us see how thesaurus feature is useful in MS Word. Thesaurus actually represents the synonyms of a particular word. On the screen you can see one poem is written there. I have to find out the synonyms of the word dark. I have selected the word dark. Right click on it. Then you can see synonyms option is there. It shows the corresponding synonyms for the particular word. Automatically, that will be replaced with the synonyms word. This can be done in another ways too. Click on the review tab. Under the proofing group, you can see thesaurus option is there. Click on it. Then it shows the synonyms words of the selected word. We can use a shortcut key shift plus F7 to do the same process. We have learned now several editing features like cut, copy, paste, find and replace, spelling and grammar check, and thesaurus option. I am concluding today's session. Thank you.